हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज भूषण पाटिल, टीचर ऑफ दिनिक एकेडमी पुणे। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ दिनिक एकेडमी पुणे। दिस वीडियो इज अबाउट ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन, ब्रीफ इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द टेस्ट सीरीज फॉर यूपीएससी प्रीलिम एग्जामिनेशन 2021। वी आर लॉन्चिंग यूपीएससी प्री टेस्ट सीरीज 2021 फ्रॉम 10th of January 2021। So I will give you here brief information about the schedule, means how we are conducting this test series. I will give you here information about the design of this test series, means how we are setting this question papers and questions. I will also tell you about the important features of this test series and how this test series will help you in your journey of UPSC examination. I will give you assurance that this test series will definitely help you to reach very closer to success. So let's see now how we have designed this test series. So first we start with the schedule of this test series. Friends, we have divided this test series into two phases, phase first and phase second. So first, let's talk about the phase first. So is phase first, actually we have given this name to this phase first as a basic difficulty level. So why this basic difficulty level for the phase first? So first of all, we will develop your conceptual clarity. In the phase first, we will develop questions on basic concepts of different topics. This will help you to build your foundation for the advanced level question or the UPSC level questions. Through this first phase, you will understand your level of understanding of different concepts, and if you have any problem in understanding certain concepts, that will be revealed through these questions and you will get help to clear your concepts. Here you see we have divided this first phase into seven topic-wise tests plus two comprehensive tests. Now UPSC questions are not of this level questions. These are slightly simple question than the UPSC question, but these are important to build your foundation. Now here, in every test, we are opening two subjects. Why two subjects? Because when you prepare only one subject for a complete 1 week or 2 weeks, then you feel slightly bored, monotonous, or you feel pressure that you are just reading one subject. That's why to make you more comfortable, to build your confidence, in every test, we are opening two subjects plus current event. So that will also I will tell you that how we are covering that part. Like suppose test first, that is on 10th of January. On 10th of January, there will be two topics we are opening up. That is a polity part, polity test first, and history test first. Now here in polity, suppose test first, which questions we will ask? That we will tell you in advance by giving you brief syllabus of this test. After this slide, I will show you that syllabus also, how we have divided this test series into a detailed syllabus. So in advance, you will get syllabus. On that syllabus, we will try to cover question on each and every topic so that you will not miss concept from even a single topic. Means our effort will be to set question or to cover all the topics or all the subtopics of the subjects. Now here on 10th of January, we will ask question on the June current events, then on the next test, July current events. In this way, we'll finish up to December current events till the first phase. And in the second phase, we'll cover current events from January to May plus revision of the previous month's current events. So here, another important feature of this phase first and phase second also, I will tell you about this miscellaneous part. You can see this miscellaneous part, miscellaneous type of question. We have devoted one test for this miscellaneous type of questions and GK question. Now, what is this type? Miscellaneous type means what? You see, nowadays UPSC is asking question on different topics together, or where it is difficult to decide that this question is asked from which topic exactly, means from current events or from science and technology or from polity. UPSC related that question with the material which is used for the road construction. And UPSC ask question on the asphalt, cold mix asphalt and the hot mix asphalt. So we are trying to develop certain question of this category so that we will prepare you to face this type of miscellaneous type of question. We will try to create linkages from current event and from basic subject to miscellaneous topics. So this will prepare you for the difficult type of question which UPSC is asking nowadays. So in this way, this first phase is divided or distributed into 7 tests plus 2 comprehensive tests. So why 2 comprehensive tests here? Because you will revise all topics once you are clear or read all these basic concepts or the basic information about all these subjects. Then in second phase, actually, which is starting from 14th of March, we will set questions of UPSC level difficulty that we have given name, that is advanced level difficulty level or applied level difficulty level or UPSC difficulty level. Here UPSC type of question we will set, and the syllabus pattern is same which we have conducted actually test in the phase first. So same topics are here. So we can see here miscellaneous topic. So same here, but here level will be advanced level. So here you can compare your understanding with the understanding of your colleagues or marks of your colleagues. So how we will compare it, that also I will tell you in next information. So in phase second, we will take 4 comprehensive tests. So there will be total 6 comprehensive tests, 2 comprehensive tests in phase first and 4 comprehensive tests in phase second. In this way, there will be 6 comprehensive tests. Then next, actually how we have divided this syllabus or subject into a number of subtopics, that is given here. This is just one slide of that syllabus. When you will take admission or you will give test series, you will get detailed syllabus with the UPSC this test series schedule. Like suppose test first is on the polity part and modern Indian history part. You see here polity syllabus is given in detail. This is just first phase, just for information. So here like evolution of the constitution, then preamble, then citizenship, fundamental duties, etc. Now here we will set question on each and every subtopic so that not even a single topic you will miss from your preparation. So this will reveal your loopholes also in which particular subtopic you are weak. So by considering all these factors, we have developed this detailed syllabus. Now next slide, that is about the important feature of this test series. So 2-3 points are very important here. Like all test series, all points we are including here, all important features here we are including here. But I will tell you some specific points. Like suppose first point is common, that we are taking 20 tests on GS plus 5 tests on the CSAT. So there will be total 25 tests. And this 5 tests on CSAT we will take along with the comprehensive test that we will take at the end of this test series. Second feature, CSAT test will be provided along with the comprehensive test series that just now I told you. Then advanced and applied levels of difficulty, that also we have discussed. Then intensive discussion on each test by expert faculty. Now this is important point. In every test actually, after completing this test, 2 teachers will discuss that test. Like suppose test first, polity and history. So 2 teachers, polity teacher and history teacher, will discuss that test series, because they know the perspective behind setting these questions. That's why their involvement or their participation is important, and this is an important feature of this test series. And they will not discuss the information, because already we will give that information in explanation. They will discuss the perspective behind asking this question. How you can reach to conclusion, how to use different skill set to answer that question, or which understanding was needed to solve that question or to answer that question properly. So 2 teachers will discuss every test according to topics, and they will give importance to the hidden information, hidden conceptual clarity, which generally cannot be given or not possible to give into explanation of these answers. Then next, special focus on developing skill set for objective examination. You can see this topic. Now skill sets, this is important point. Now which skill sets are required for UPSC prelim examination? Like suppose how to reach to conclusion, means how to think logically, then mnemonics techniques, intuition technique. So when teachers will discuss with you this different question, they will also discuss these different skill sets, how you can develop these skill sets, like suppose polity questions. So I'm setting polity question paper or questions, my colleagues, our team. So when I will discuss polity questions, I will discuss the important skill sets like mnemonics. Remembering particular factual information, which mnemonics you can use, how mnemonics can be prepared. So to prepare mnemonics is important skill set which is required for prelim examination. Then intuition means suppose when you write particular answer, when you mark particular answer, so sometime actually that feeling comes from inside you that this is the answer. But we give logic and we mark wrong answer. So how to actually build confidence and to mark the answer which coming first from your mind. So this intuition is exactly what that concept we will try to clear at the time of discussion. Then about the comprehensive coverage of syllabus that I told you. We are giving you detailed syllabus. That's why the system itself is giving you assurity, or this is forcing us to set question on all topics. So that comprehensive syllabus can be covered in this way. Then last one, All India Ranking and Progress Assessment. Means what? Once you give your test, you will submit your answer sheets or your score, and we will give you ranking. From that ranking, you can understand exactly where you stand in this preparation level. And suppose after 2 tests, 3 tests or 4 tests, it is not possible to for you to improve your rank. So you can discuss with your faculty members, with our mentors, that what exactly problem you are facing, whether you are lacking in information, conceptual clarity or skill set which are required to clear prelim examination. So we'll help you, we will assist you to improvise your skill set and to improve your ranking. You can also see, or you can also discuss with your colleagues who are getting more marks or better marks. So which factors are helping them to score more? So that also we'll try to discuss in discussion, or you can discuss with faculty members and they will help you to improve your progress. Now next thing, this is important thing. These are UPSC pre-question type analysis. Now we have analyzed previous year UPSC questions, question papers, and segregated these questions into number of types. Now here, this almost 8 types are given here. I will give you here brief information about these types. Like suppose, first, match the pairs. You can see 2018, 19 and 20, around 6 questions are asked on the match the pairs. So we'll try to maintain this type of distribution in the test series. Then you see 2 statements. So second point, 2 statements. Means UPSC give you statement 1, statement 2, and ask you like which of the above statements are right or is correct. And they give you answer only 1, only 2, both, neither 1 nor 2. So this type of questions in 2018 and 19, there were 12 to 17 questions. But in 2020, these questions are reduced. UPSC asked just 6 questions. Means this is relatively simple type. This UPSC is reducing. Then you can see the third type. In third type, actually 3 statements UPSC gives you. Means statement 1, 2, 3. And in option, UPSC asks you like which of the above statements are correct. Like 1, 2, 2, 3, etc. So this question, this proportion is similar. That 27 were asked in 2018 and 2020 also, 28 questions are asked. So this proportion is maintained here. But you see, question number or type number 4 and 5, these are simple ABCD type of questions. Only some questions in some type, this ABCD type of questions are long statement and small statement. So combinedly, when you will see in 2018, almost 42 to 45 questions were asked. Similarly, here in 2019, around 48 to 50 questions were asked of ABCD type. But you see in 2020, around 40 questions are asked of ABCD type. Means this type is also reduced. See, 2 statement type questions are reduced and simple ABCD type of questions are also reduced. And what UPSC did, you see directly this 7 here statement or category. In 7 category means UPSC gives us 4 statements, like statement 1, statement 2, statement 3 and statement 4. And they ask you in option A like 1, 2, 3, option B 2, 3, 4, etc. So these are more difficult type of question. Now you see that proportion here, 7 category. Only 3 to 9 question UPSC asks used to ask in the previous years or ask in previous years. But in 2020, you see that proportion is increased. Almost 17 questions are asked on this type. Means statement 1, 2, 3, 4 and ABCD in this way. So this proportion we will try to maintain in the test series so that you will face the same difficulty level while solving question. Means it will take more time to read it like UPSC actual examination. Means we will not make it difficult unnecessarily. We'll try to make it lengthy also compared to UPSC examination. Compared to means like UPSC examination. UPSC papers are slightly lengthy. So we have analyzed that question types also. And we set question in that format. So we'll try to maintain this distribution. So this was brief introduction about this test series. And another thing, this test series, our whole team, unique team, is developing all these questions. Means almost 2 teachers per subject are developing questions. So that you will get perspective from different teachers. Means not only from 2 or 3 persons or 4 persons, but you will get this question types, analysis of UPSC from this team, all team. We are doing this deliberately so that student will get perspective from all angle. So thank you friends for listening this video. And I assure you that definitely you will get advantages from this test series. And I give you all the best for your future and for success in the UPSC prelim examination. Thank you.
Subscribe the Unique Academy's YouTube channel and press the bell icon for latest updates and videos.